hello and welcome back. Let's get started with one of those bad boys right there. So I just wanted to put this video out in regards to some talk about Carvin Audio closing. And it is true that they are closing their factory in San Diego, California. I actually heard directly from the president of Carvin Audio, Carson Kiesel, and he did mention in an email to me directly that they are closing the factory in San Diego. With that said, Kristen and Joel, who are Carson's two children, will be continuing with the Carvin Audio brand. They'll be, in the short term, continuing with the pedals that are already out there, the Steve Vai pedal, and there's also some other pedals that are on the horizon, which I'm actually really excited about. I can't mention what pedals, but if you think about the amps that they make, you may expect to see some of that in a pedal form. So, is it true that Carvin Audio is closing? The factory in San Diego is closing, and that just happened as of yesterday. But Carson's two kids, Joel and Kristen, will be continuing with the Carvin Audio name with pedals and accessories. And that's all the information I have for you right now. Now, as for the commentary, I think it's just a function of, we're in a heavily saturated market. And when you look at brands like Peavey, where once upon a time they were only made in the USA, I've interviewed Hartley Peavey quite a number of times in the past, and the reality is it's really expensive to do business and to keep manufacturing here. Kind of the odds are against you with manufacturing in the US for a number of different reasons. And I think that maybe has caught up with Carvin Audio. Carvin Audio, it was basically, if you could hit rewind by a couple of years now, Carvin used to be the guitar line, the Pro Audio line, and the amplifier line, and that got split in half. Mark Kiesel and his son Jeff went to the Kiesel line, and Carson Kiesel, with his son Joel and daughter Kristen, went to the Carvin Audio line, and that company, split. So I think for the Pro Audio and the amplifier side of the house, I think it was probably too expensive to do business here. I certainly don't know what the Pro Audio line looks like or the amplifier line, but I think it's probably easier for somebody to buy a guitar because most of the time it's an impulse buy. Us guitarists love a new guitar day, but I don't know how many people do new Pro Audio day. And I think it's probably very taxing on a business to maintain that kind of overhead in a US manufacturing facility. And again, this is my opinion. I'm curious to know what you think, so leave your comments below. But that's kind of the news right there. Carvin Audio is closing its facility in San Diego. Carson's two kids will be continuing with the name with pedals and accessories. And that's kind of the latest and greatest update that I received directly from Carson Kiesel, who's the president of Carvin Audio. With that said, I do want to make a note that I have a soft spot in my heart for Carvin. I grew up with Carvin, thumbing through catalogs when I first started playing guitar. I was one of the first people to buy the Quad-X preamp, something I still own, which is right over there. The T100 power amp, something which I own, still own, is right over there. I've had the several X100Bs. Oh, where is it? Right over here. One is an 80s, one is a 90s model. Phenomenal USA made amps for not a lot of money. And that was always their mantra. Good quality USA made amps for not a lot of money. But I think that may have caught up with them because it's so expensive to do business here, which is one of the reasons why you see companies like Peavey, who only, like Carvin, used to only be made in the USA, and now a bulk of their manufacturing depends on imported goods, like the Mini Series, which is right over here. They're all imported now because I think that's what you need to do to compete in today's market. Okay, so leave your comments below. Let me know what you think, but hopefully that set the record straight on where Carvin Audio is today. Thank you for watching this video. I'll leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. Thank you, rock on, and we'll see you later.